Okay, so I was just now trying to get to bed, trying to get to sleep, when I realized I want to practice a few specific things. If you're a writer, you know that sometimes when you're getting to sleep, there you get a flash of inspiration. So it's kind of similar to that, but with the guitar. I got a flash of inspiration as to what to practice. And I'll try not to be too loud. So, if you've been watching the videos, sorry, I have to adjust some things here. Been watching the videos, you know, I'm working on two separate songs. Mostly I'm just working scales, but where's the volume? Okay, so I hope that's not too loud because I'm really gonna go for it. Okay, so basically, I want to. Want to get this done good. Basically, that progression is the beginning of a song I'm working on, and I don't know where to go after that. But this is all self-generated. I learned the chords separately. I spent probably about 50 hours learning different chords, and then I got into an experimental phase, and I came up with this, but I realize that whenever I go back to this during my long chord practice, as you just saw, it takes time to go from chord to chord smoothly. So I'm practicing a repetition of the different chords. See, I'm not hitting that right when I go to it. These ones are easy. That's where the mistake comes in. Yeah, I'm muting it. It almost sounded right, but it was wrong, obviously, so. that's very close, but it's not perfect. And I have grooves in my finger from repetition. This is right. You see, that's wrong too. It's getting better. First of all, I'm tired. It's 2:30 a.m. And second of all, when I'm pulling off the C major, I'm using my pinky on the fifth string instead of my ring finger on the fifth string, because I find typically it's easier to get there that way. But then I have to remember to push. And I have to also make sure I'm not muting neighboring strings. So, we go, what is this, G6? May as well just look up what we're doing. So we go, G6. Then we go, what is the next one here? I know this is a chord, C major 7. And then we go to A7. Yeah, so if we just slow it down, maybe it's easier. And there, that's the basic. That's a scale of chords that I have designed for myself, and I don't know how to represent that. I mean, I guess I could try to represent it into a picture. Anyways, the other thing I wanted to work on, and I wanted to get for this video, I want to go back and forth between these two practices, because in a way, these are the most important. And we still haven't perfected a proper way to strum with the pick. So, okay, we did that. Let's do it again, because I lost my fingers. I think I feel a little bit crazy right now. Attempting the chord without any manual adjustment. This one's a lot harder for some reason. Thank you. two things. First of all, I practiced it with the index at the 7 more often than I practiced it with the index at the 5. And second of all, I forgot what else I was going to say. I'm really tired, and I think I might be a little bit crazy. Seems I have to push harder with my index on the 5 than I do on the 7. And then on the 3, we only have the one string. And I think it's pretty obtainable with just some, I mean, it's not something I can go to quickly, but pattern is on the 5. So the 5 has both the barred 5th and 6th and the single 6th with the ring finger and pinky 2 frets down, or if this is 1 fret, that's 2 frets down in the position beneath the string that is pressed. So if the bar is 2 strings, the pinky is the string below the 1, 2, 3, so the pinky is at 3, which is actually 4 because the bottom is 1. I think this makes sense to people who know what I'm talking about. The other problem is that the middle finger is floating, and in order for proper hand coordination, the float sometimes gets a little bit too close to the actual strings, and when you go like that, if you're really low, the string will bounce and it'll hit, it'll like, I think it just vibrates like all over the place. Also, if your mind gets sloppy, the combination of it vibrating upwards maybe, I don't know if it does vibrate upwards, but that's my perception. It vibrates upwards, and also at the same time, you're pushing downwards with your other fingers because it's especially important to push downwards with these chords. And the result is the floating middle finger sometimes touches the third chord, the third string in this case, which mutes it, which diminishes the sound that you're trying to achieve. Yeah, basically it's just whatever, not very important, and let's just go through it a few times. You heard it, but my middle finger, which is floating, and floating means not pressing down, so my middle finger, the float, it came into contact with the first string. Now let's start over without talking. if I'm learning anything here. There's a reason why the pinky is on the fourth string and the ring is on the third. Well, now the ring is on the third. No, the ring was on the third and the pinky was on the fourth. And that's the way it's represented in the video that I'm trying to copy. But let's experiment with the ring on the fourth and the pinky on the third, because we're muting the second. Thing I was saying, but we just have to make sure that the ring is positioned upwards. Just shook, but they did, and now my hand hurts, so I just stretch that out, and now, okay, so I think I kind of like wrecked my hand trying to practice those chords. So back to my song, my original song, unless someone else came up with it for me, which probably happened. I think that's all I'm gonna do for now. I really wanted to just go over it again and again and again and again, but that's what my hand can take. And I have coffee brewing for those interested. It is 2:48 a.m. I have one more anxiety pill left to take. I would like to sleep if I could, but I can't, so I'm making coffee and I'm going to copy word for word a dictionary into a page of a notebook of blank pages. Okay, I am crazy.